simply the greatest. 12-time world champion Demetrious Johnson makes his much-anticipated debut at ONE Championship. Champion Yuya Wakamatsu says he is ready to become the ONE Flyweight Tournament champ. Inside the sold-out Rio Gokokopika in Tokyo, it's ONE Championship, a new era. All-time world champion Demetrious Johnson, a tournament champion. Yuya Wakamatsu.
Watch DJ's forward pressure. He's constantly switching stances. He advances his stance as he punches. So as he throws weapons, he's constantly changing. It's incredibly difficult to read, and that's the danger of it. If he mixes in the takedown so very well. But good job by Yuya Wakamatsu to press DJ up against the cage. Wakamatsu's got to separate here.
Sneaky knees on the inside from Demetrious Johnson. Threads one high, then goes down to the thighs of Wakamatsu. Wakamatsu breaks free, back to center cage. Opening 45 seconds, plenty of action thus far.
That first minute is going to get Yuya Wakamatsu confidence, especially with that striking. He's going to be able to, if he realizes he can stop the takedown of DJ, he's going to throw with a little bit heavier shots.
Plenty of movement here from Demetrious Johnson. High kick from DJ. Mighty Mouse goes upstairs. And we will see Wakamatsu let his hands go. That high knockout right on Yuya Wakamatsu. And we're on the ground for the first time. And look at Johnson go to work. Now back on their feet. Johnson sinking a double leg.
Good sprawl by Yuya, but you can't just stop one takedown. You have to stop a chain of takedowns that come off of DJ. He continuously attacks. But good job by Yuya Wakamatsu. Now he's got to go chest to chest. He's got to break the grip, and he's got to spin him around and put his chest to the chest of DJ.
The most anticipated debut in the world. The ONE Championship debut of Mighty Mouse Demetrious Johnson, the greatest flyweight of all time. Now it's Johnson on his back. Wakamatsu inside the guard, and the crowd here inside the Rio Gokokopika loves it.
Good job by Yuya Wakamatsu to stop that single leg that DJ attempted and spin around and add in the guard of DJ. Let's see how quick he got back up.
And listen to the charm, Yuya, here in Tokyo. As DJ was making his way back up. Sneaky there from Wakamatsu, back to center cage. 2:35 remains in the first. A tantalizing opening round. Fakes there from Wakamatsu. Fake there from Johnson. Southpaw stance for Demetrious. Now the orthodox. High knee from Demetrious Johnson. They clinch up once more. Johnson forced against the cage. Overhook of the right arm of Wakamatsu. What does Wakamatsu look to do from here, Dragon?
Right now he's just trying to slow DJ down. You know, he's got the underhook on the right side, and now he's got the underhook on both sides. Now he's got double underhooks. Now if he can create a little bit of separation here, he can jack up that side on the right side of DJ's arm and work to the back. And here he can drive it. There's that separation.
Held up the job, and Jenny Kingad already through to the semifinal round of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. Inside thigh kick, nicely done there from Demetrious Johnson.
Now, DJ is used to going 5 rounds. He has been through 13 straight 5-round matches, and so this is the first time he's been in 3 rounds in a long time. So he's usually used to pacing himself. How is that going to factor into this match?
First time competing in Japan for Mighty Mouse Demetrious Johnson. Left foot there from Johnson, counter left from Wakamatsu, the high up roundhouse kick.
Yuya Wakamatsu's looking really good in his first 4 minutes, but he always looks good in the first round. How is he going to favor in the second and third round when DJ starts to shift up gears?
It's a really good feeling that DJ is just dipping his toes in the proverbial water here. Seeing what Wakamatsu has to offer, what angles he comes at, what technique he throws, off what side. shooting double leg takedown there from Demetrious Johnson.
Beautiful takedown from DJ as he laces up the legs. Yuya Wakamatsu's got to try to get back up. He's going to try to create a little bit of space with his hips. Let's see how DJ's got that body lock, and he's able to scoop the hips out and easily passes into side control. This is where DJ's dangerous. He's got to watch that fall arm. He's going to go for the kimura on this side. And that right arm of Yuya Wakamatsu. Watch him try to pin that arm to the ground, and he's going to go hunt for a kimura.
Wakamatsu gets that far arm free, still in side control, cuts a hip in a little bit. Demetrious Johnson, great forward's idea of the action. Wakamatsu back to his feet, the crowd enjoy it. A round of applause inside the sold-out Rio Goku Koku Gikan in Tokyo.
That was nice by Yuya Wakamatsu to keep that little bit of space and get back up to his feet. Very entertaining round. I know many people didn't expect to go this far.
Heavyweight champion of the world, Brandon Vera, in the house here at the Rio Goku Koku Gikan, along with our many luminaries cage side. For the biggest show in history, it's one championship, a new era.
Look at the greatest flyweight world champion putting in work. Throws that kick, switches stances. It's so hard to get a read on DJ. Look at that. Throws the hook, attacks the legs, finishes the double leg. Look at that head position. That head driving into the body of Yuya Wakamatsu. And then he started to suck the legs so he could keep the hips away from the cage so Yuya wasn't able to get back up. DJ slowly starting to figure this out. He was able to get into side control, start looking for the submission, wasn't able to get it. But Yuya Wakamatsu is doing a good job of stopping all of DJ's takedown advances. He's able to get back up to his feet and showcase good, so far, submission defense.
The Pancrase Flyweight Tournament champion, Wakamatsu, a 12-time world flyweight champion, Demetrious Johnson. And Johnson bounds out of his corner.
You can see a little bit of damage on the right eye of DJ. Those punches from Yuya Wakamatsu are heavy.
Wakamatsu goes digging to the liver. Off that left hand, straight right down the center corridor. A beautiful counter from Wakamatsu. Sprawls out nicely, Wakamatsu. Jab two from Wakamatsu, the heavy artillery. And DJ wants him down. DJ gets him down. Ties up those legs, presses him against the cage. On his back now.
Yuya got a little bit overexcited. He started to hunt. After he wobbled DJ a little bit, he went after him. And that was able DJ to duck under and secure that takedown. This is where DJ is very impressive. Watch him slowly make adjustments and work into side control.
And he goes, he passes from half guard to side control. Tries to pin the arm. And Wakamatsu back to his feet. Well done from Yuya again. Tucks the back standing as DJ. Wakamatsu tries to turn back into him. What scrambles, what a contact. Now DJ wants to try and choke it.
Good job by Yuya. He's able to create separation in the hands, turn his back to his body, but he can't stop. He has to continually defend because DJ is relentless.
Demetrious Johnson more moves than U-Haul here in the second round. Referee Olivia Coast right on top of the action. Wakamatsu could be in trouble.
He's got it looks like he's going for a choke. You can see he's got the side of the neck. It's like a no-arm arm triangle, but you can see that he's going for a rear naked choke. But good job by Yuya to scramble out of it. Now he's sitting in the mat. It's a bad spot. Look for the elbows. Watch the elbows on the ground and pound of DJ. He doesn't want to lose this position. He chooses actually to leave mount and go into side control. And I know what he's looking for. He's looking for a kimura.
Fans.
Big hello to all of our viewers in the US watching on TNT. Hope you're enjoying all the action of one championship, all the action of Mighty Max, Demetrious Johnson.
She's framing off the face, just slides that elbow in. You can see he's trying to crucifix the arm. He's going to take that right arm of Yuya, put it between his legs so he can isolate, drop a little bit of ground. Here comes the kimura. He's looking for it. Good job by Yuya. Stuck nice and tight on the arms.
Johnson hunting for a finish as we approach the halfway mark of this contest. As Mitch said earlier, it's been a long, long time since Demetrious Johnson has been in a three-rounder. Now can he tuck that arm home? No, not yet. Here's some knees to the collarbone. Demetrious trying to choke it. Can he get it? Can he get it? That's the night I read! Hold on, wait a minute. Let me put some DJ in it.
Wow, he was able to get that choke from a nasty position. Didn't even have the full proper positioning. That's how tight the world champion squeeze is.
Demetrious Johnson, successful on his one championship debut, and he moves through to the semi-finals of the World Flyweight Grand Prix. That is why he's the greatest of all time. That's Mighty Mouse Demetrious Johnson.
Look at this, has the guillotine. Yuya Wakamatsu did everything he could to try to avoid that, but look how tight that is. Look at the guillotine. You can see Yuya Wakamatsu tries to turn out of it. He tries to angle out, but look at that. Oh, that's a nasty position. That's how tight that is. Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson just moves forward in the one Flyweight World Grand Prix.
Have a look at the squeeze from Mighty Mouse. Locks out moisture, seals in freshness. Good night, Irene.
Well, Yuya Wakamatsu did a really good job in the first half of that match. He was stopping a lot of takedowns, showcasing good striking. Very impressive performance from Yuya Wakamatsu. DJ is the best flyweight in the world, and Yuya Wakamatsu was in there to the very end.
Let's go to Tom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of guillotine choke, Demetrious Johnson!
Welcome to ONE Championship, Demetrious Johnson. The greatest of all time takes the winner's medal and takes his place in the semi-finals of the World Flyweight Grand Prix. Southpaw stance on the Cuban, the Olympic wrestler, Gustavo Balart. Orthodox stance on Wada, who's using a lot of the circle early on. Three-time deep flyweight world champion, Tatsumitsu Wada. Crowd here in Manila, electrified for this one. Lots of excitement.
Is an Olympic wrestler from Cuba, and he's also spent a lot of time working with the Olympic boxing teams out there in Cuba, and now he's relocated to Miami, and so he gets some really good training partners out there in Miami as well. Tatsumitsu Wada likes to close the distance. He likes to take people down and put them on their back. That's what we saw against Kingad.
Wada continues to move around the circle here. Overhand left there from the southpaw Balart. Drift back to center circle. Balart so powerfully built. Cracks that left hook. There's an uppercut from the Cuban. But this is the target. Love to see what happens if Balart shoots in, gets a takedown, puts Wada on his back. Or if Wada gets a takedown, puts the wrestler on his back. Inside leg kick from Balart. Overhand left from Balart. He is loading up on that overhand left. The rear hand of the southpaw. Balart comes after him again, hunting with that left hand. The power still with the Cuban. Balart certainly the aggressor early on. Wants to get on the inside, wants to land the power salvo. That left hand's cocked and ready.
Ready to go. Inside leg kick, and he closes that distance, and there comes the overhand left.
What is cut over the left eye, it looks like. Already the damage inflicted by Gustavo Balart. The Olympic wrestler from Cuba against a three-time deep flyweight world champion from Japan. Jab from Wada. Good leg kick there from Wada. Fake from Wada. Lots of instructions coming from the Cuban corner of Gustavo Balart. El Gladiador.
I'd like to see Wada use more straight linear weapons, straight punches, to utilize that jab, at least start touching, you know, Balart, because Ballard's getting very comfortable throwing that big left hand. I'd like to see him start throwing push kicks right up the middle. There's some straight shots.
Two punch combination lands there for Wada, so to the left hook from Balart. Sitting quite soon, the knuckles in, the Cuban wrestler, 2 minutes remaining, first round of three. Quarterfinal number four of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. Step up, side kick to the elite knee there from Balart. Wada angles, lateral movement. Balart wants to throw that left hook again. You can smell it, you can sense it on the Cuban. It's a high-lift roundhouse kick. And he goes to the inside lead leg.
See, Wada's having a hard time with that range and that distance from Balart. But Ballard's very accustomed to this type of differential, this type of range advantage. So you can start to see him, he's very comfortable jumping in and throwing a shot. He attempts a, looked like maybe a jumping switch knee followed by an overhand left.
It's all a striking contest in the opening round so far. Ballard's edging forward. Powerfully built thighs on the Cuban. Shoulders, and there's a high kick from the wrestler. Goes to the inside leg, high up in that femoral profunda. Overhand left from Balart. Threads the jab. Wada, the sweeper. Outside leg kick from Balart, lifted the leg off the canvas. Goes a second bite at the cherry. Right hand down the tube from Tatsumitsu Wada. Cuts open up a little more above the left eye of Wada. Wada calling Balart forward. What's the count of the Cuban? Overhand left there from Balart. Fake from Balart. Tracking right hand. Smack bang on the kisser there from Wada. And Balart does a quick count of his teeth. Sticks out the jab, does the Cuban. Fakes and feints from Tatsumitsu Wada. Skip up roundhouse kick there from Gustavo Balart. Tries to get on the inside. Wada just loses his footing. Into the round we go to the town. Crowd is loving Gustavo Balart in Manila.
Is Balart getting airborne here as he tries to take Tatsumitsu Wada out as he jumps in with the switching kick, follows it up with a left hand. But then Wada starts to get a little bit more comfortable with this reach advantage that he's got and starts to put him out there. He starts to feel out Balart and then he starts to throw those hands a little bit more aggressively. There's a straight right hand that touched up the face there of Gustavo Balart. Now, I'd like to see, I'm surprised at this point, to be quite honest with you, Michael. We barely even see any takedown attempts. This is an Olympic wrestler who is choosing to strike with Tatsumitsu Wada. It's a very interesting point at this juncture right now.
Second round of quarterfinal number four of the Flyweight World Grand Prix.
Back
inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines.
Watch
who will
head,
go
okay?
Through to the semi-finals to join Mighty Mouse Demetrious Johnson.
Guys, back, please.
Former
back,
world
back.
Champion Kairat Akhmetov.
Ready?
Large opening a cut, inflicting damage on Wada.
Guys, watch on your head.
Down.
See, I think that headbutt, how Wada comes in like that, that's how the headbutt, that was that cut got opened up in his eye.
Wada with the jab. Balart in southpaw stance. Tried time and time again for the overhand left in the opening stanza. Inside leg kick from Balart, who has outstruck Tatsumitsu Wada, the three-time deep flyweight world champion. As Mitch said, very surprising. Like of takedown attempts from both men, particularly from Balart, given his career as a multiple wrestling champion and an Olympic wrestler back in the 2012 London Games.
But he's having a lot of success. He's having a lot of success here on his feet. You know, he doesn't feel maybe he needs to take, you know, Wada down, or he wants to take him down because he's so having so much success throwing that left hand and that inside low kick as well.
Is it difficult here for Wada? I mean, Wada's faced shorter opponents before Mitch, but never someone 20 centimeters shorter. And having to punch down, I guess.
against Balart, does that pose problems for the three-time deep champion?
Well, Tatsumitsu Wada's game is, you know, to punch, close the distance, and then work for takedowns and get people onto their back and start grinding them on top position. You know, but so this is a very awkward style to punch down like this, you know, and he hasn't quite gotten comfortable with it. I'd like to see him throw more kicks.
Now there's a cut, it looks like, to the side of Balart's right arm.
See, I think that could be the headbutts. Because they're clashing heads. They're having a difficulty. Wada's rushing in, throwing shots, and they're
both of you. Last time, headbutt. Watch out.
Okay. Okay.
Let's take a look at some of these headbutts, because I think it's not one person's particular fault. I think it's just the style that they're doing. You know, as Wada's coming in, he's trying to change levels maybe, or at least feint, and they're just slamming heads. I think it's happened multiple times. See, Wada's coming in, Balart ducks underneath to throw that left hand, and Wada is just slamming his head into Balart because of the height differential.
So it was Wada who was leading with his head on that occasion.
But I think it's happened more than once. I think that's like the third time that's happened. It's, you know, it's Wada slamming his head into Gustavo Balart.
Wada is allowed 5 minutes for medical examination here and recovery. He's okay to go on. See some damage on both men's faces and foreheads. Flyweight World Grand Prix quarterfinal number four. Between Gustavo Balart, the Olympic wrestler from Cuba, and the three-time deep flyweight world champion from Japan, Tatsumitsu Wada. Cracking roundhouse kick there from Wada off the right leg. Balart chasing it. Wada caging. Has experience. Has all the tricks in the book. While looping left hand there from Balart. Jump ball in the top from Balart on the inside. Hooking off both hands now. More hooks than a Pirates convention for Gustavo Balart. Skip up roundhouse kick from the Cuban. Enjoying the striking tonight. High kick from Balart. No takedown attempt still here.
Watch out.
Gustavo Balart, El Gladiador.
He was trying to curtwheel kick there, apparently. Drop down on his side. But again, they're clashing heads again.
Another caution.
I don't think it's Balart jumping up and trying to headbutt Wada. I think Wada is the one coming down onto the headbutt.
It's Wada again coming down with his head, and that time it was a headbutt jaw. So it's Wada's jaw coming down on the head of Balart. I didn't see Balart's head come up on that occasion.
Yeah, it's not like he's jumping up trying to headbutt him. Like, you can see Wada's trying to change levels, and he's getting very tight, you know, in the exchange.
Ready? Two!
Because he has to change levels to try to match the height of...
Guys, watch out! Let's go!
There, Wada leading with his head.
Yeah, you see how he's crouching forward like this? He's trying to get nice and tight, nice and low. It's weird to try to see an athlete match the height of his opponent.
Jump ball getting left hand there from Balart, the house on fire! And just got out of dodge in time to Tatsumitsu Wada. Balart again skips forward. That left hand's ready to go. Slings the legs. Wada looks for a counter. 150 remains, second round of three. Scoops out the kicking lead, does Balart. Makes that. Jumping roundhouse kick from Balart. Certainly the more active of the two is El Gladiador, Gustavo Balart of Cuba. He's popping right hand from Wada, overhand left from Balart, tries for the uppercut.
Wada's doing a good job of throwing that left hand and touching Wada. I'd like to see Wada throw more of the jab. It's right there. It's like his reach should be easily touched. Like he should easily be able to reach out and tap Balart in the face. But it's like Wada's waiting for the takedown, and that's why he's changing levels so low. And he's keeping his hands low so he can possibly dig for underhooks.
But is Wada's strategy moving, causing Balart to be the one scoring on him? Balart the busier of the two. He's the aggressor of the two. So, you know, Wada's letting valuable time slip away, but he's really not doing a lot here, Mitch.
There's a nice little right hand
thrown by Wada that landed on the entry as he was coming in.
But then he didn't pounce on Balart. He had an opportunity there to capitalize. He took more damage.
This is what I've seen in a lot of Balart's matches. Like the second round, he has a tendency to fade. He starts to get a little bit slower in his movement, not quite as aggressive. And this is where his, like, in his one loss that he has, where he got hit with a jump flying knee, he was getting picked apart on the feet that led up to it.
Southpaw stance on Gustavo Balart. Rides the roundhouse kick, looks for a left-hand counter. Final seconds of the second round. Good right hand, speed and accuracy there from Wada. Not so the overhand left of Gustavo Balart. One more round to go in quarterfinal number four of the Flyweight World Grand Prix.
Here's Balart, Superman, punching his way into the entry right there. And then I'm surprised not a takedown came. These guys are just choosing to stand and trade. There's that jab from Wada. See, it works when he puts it out there. But then again, he throws the punches, he circles out, he's gone. He's constantly dropping down, trying to get nice and crouched, which is an interesting strategy.
Inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines, will it be the Cuban Olympic wrestler? Or will it be the Japanese three-time deep flyweight world champion who goes through to the semi-final round? A magnificent quarter-final matchup brought to you this one by Global Citizen.
That's wrong. Watch out, okay?
Third and final. It is either man's for the taking. Who wants to dig down deep?
Back, please, back.
Into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude.
Ready? Ready?
Who wants to put the foot on the turbochargers now, on the burners, and really light this one up? Right-hand lead, and then Gustavo Balart backs off Wada.
With every combination, Wada is dropping his head down and then almost trying to push off of Gustavo Balart. So he'll throw a shot, get nice and tight, drop his head down, and then push off.
Balart has not attempted, I don't believe, one takedown attempt. Have you seen one yet from Balart? Does it surprise you given the caliber of this Olympic wrestler, this multiple Greco-Roman wrestling champion?
I'm surprised on a lot of different levels with this matchup, the way that it's going. There's a nice little knee from Wada. In every single one of his matches, up until that big knockout that Gustavo Balart got, he was taking people down and smashing on them. But now, the Olympic wrestler wants to strike. He got the feeling of what it feels like to knock somebody out, and I think that's what he wants now.
There is a lot of instructions coming from the corner of Wada, right next to our commentary position. He continues to circle the circle here. Balart connects with the right, not so the left uppercut. Groundhouse kick was a nice one from Wada. Balart jumping on the rear hand. Haven't seen that before. Some inventive striking here from Gustavo Balart, El Gladiador. 3 minutes 30 remaining. Third and final round for a place in the semi-finals of the Flyweight World Grand Prix.
I think the jumping is Balart's way to close distance. You know, he doesn't quite have the, you know, there's a nice little leg tap right there. Try to get that knee in.
To phrase a term of yours, Mitch, at what point does Balart look to close the show and use what he does best, his wrestling?
I don't think he's gonna. I mean, he might choose a late stage takedown just to maybe score in the judge's eyes, but like even then, he changed levels, he grabs the leg, but then he pops right back up. It's almost like he's just getting Wada to think about the takedown rather than actually attempting the takedown.
Spinning back fist and an uppercut from Balart. Came agonizingly close. The overhand right from Wada. Balart goes hunting, tips to the body, loops the left hand to the head. Uppercut, that one connected, chin through the top of the head. Gustavo Balart landing some leather now. Right hook, left hook from Balart. Another hook of the lead hand from Balart. Another hook of the backhand from Balart.
Now these guys are starting to trade. They've understood each other exactly what the other person is going to do. And Wada's actually using this change in levels or this bending down that's dropping his head to actually use it as some pretty good head movement.
Oh, stiff between the eyes, that right hand lead from Tatsumitsu Wada. 2 minutes 5 remaining, third and final round. Balart hooks him again off the lead hand. Overhand right to a left hook there from Balart. A high left roundhouse kick.
Now we're starting to see the experience.
Oh, takedown!
take it down again. The Greco-Roman champion, the Olympic wrestler.
And crunch.
He tried a second attempt at a takedown. And jukes his way out with an uppercut.
Ooh, that takedown could have been the... Like, that could have inched it forward for him in the scorecards, because up until that point, that third round was a lot of Wada right there.
Damage around the right eye, causing some problems here for Balart. Eats a right hand, the uppercut. The lead hook, the high check. 110 remains, Balart fakes. Wada again persisting with the right hand. But the three-time deep flyweight world champion is being backed up by a Cuban wrestler.
Scores. Look at that. That's three unanswered jabs by Wada.
Balart consistently, constantly wiping that eye. Jab.
Nice.
Nicely done from Wada at full extension. And I've got to agree with you, Mitch. I wonder why Wada hasn't thrown that jab all night long.
Like, they both sort of woke up in the third round to utilize their game plan, which is what they're supposed to do. I'm going right up the middle.
55 seconds on the clock, and Wada taking an accidental power strike from El Gladiador.
Man, I like those takedowns from Balart. I wish we could see some more of those.
Still one. It was thunderous.
Let's take a look at it. Is this one of them? Look at this. Boom, right up through the middle. Yep, that was it. Caught the jab, right with his face, right up the middle with his head.
I'm okay. Damage to the face there of Balart.
Eduardo,
right,
hey,
what's up? Some problems. There's a cut under the left eye. Wada glances to his corner. They're telling him, get a move on. Time is against us now.
That knee is landing. That's the, I think that's like the third or the fourth time that knee has connected. Right as Balart comes close, Wada's able to land that knee. Oh, nice two-punch combination there.
Final seconds of the final round. And here it is. We go down the judges here in Manila. Arms his chest, does El Gladiador. They believe they've won it, the Cubans. Will they go through to the semifinals and join Mighty Mouse, Kairat Akhmetov, and Denny Kingad?
But there's Balart just slapping Tatsumitsu Wada as he follows it up with a left hand, but then fake the takedown there. He gets it nice and tight. There's that left hand to the over to the high crotch. Picks Wada up, puts him down, drops a little bit of ground and pound. But Wada, he showed the experience that only 30 matches can give you. And that time, that grinding in there. And he was able to inch forward a little bit in that third round until Balart was able to land that takedown. I'm interested to see how the judges saw that one. I would hate to be a judge right now. This is a tough match to score.
Let's go to Dominic Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Tatsumitsu Wada.
Tatsumitsu Wada advances to the semi-final round of the Flyweight World Grand Prix. He will join Demetrious Johnson, Kairat Akhmetov, and Denny Kingad in the final four. And he did it the very, very hard way.